It would be like the sky that's never sun.
Hi, my name is Taiwili Moshe, Pastor God's Chamber Church, Lagos. I just want to share a few thoughts with you today. Have you ever wondered why your life as a Christian is not measuring up the way it should measure up, despite the promise of God that God has given to you? Now, most times we are quick to ascribe the negative things in our lives to the devil. Yes, I agree, the devil could be responsible, but also the scripture makes us to understand that when a man is in Christ Jesus, he is now seated with Christ in the heavenly places far above. Most times, it's because we have not taken cognizance of some things that are very vital. Now, the truth of the matter is, Bible says in Isaiah chapter 1, 5 and 7, says, consider your ways. Most times you need to sit down, do a thorough appraisal of our lives, the way we have lived our lives, so that we can know where things have gone wrong. I just want to share with you a principle, which is called the seed principle. Now, Bible says in Genesis chapter 8, verse 22, that as long as the earth remains, the seed time and harvest time will not cease. You need to be very careful the kinds of seed you are sowing. Galatians chapter 6 verse 7 says, be not deceived, God is not mocked. Whatever a man sows, that will he also reap. I'm sure that most of the things that are happening in your life today are as a result of the seeds that were sown yesterday, whether consciously or unconsciously. Every day you live, you are sowing certain seeds into your life. So whatever you are seeing today is the harvest of the seed that you did sow yesterday. So you need to be very careful the kind of seeds you sow. You cannot be sowing debt and expect to reap life. It is not possible. I like the way J.B. Phillips puts it. He says, do not be under any illusion. You cannot make a fool of God. A man's harvest in life, look at it, a man's harvest in life will depend entirely on what he sows. What are you sowing daily? Then that means that you are going to reap the harvest tomorrow. If you sow negative seeds, you will reap negative harvest. If you sow positive seed, you will reap positive harvest. Quickly, I want to share some seeds that you need to learn to start sowing consciously into your life so that you can reap a good harvest tomorrow. Number one is the seed of the word. What do you say about yourself? Are you one of the people that always say what circumstances is saying about you, or you want to say what God is saying about you? I just want to challenge you and I want to instruct you today. Learn to speak what is right about your life. Bible says you are either justified or condemned by your words. Stop sowing wrong seeds over your life, over your spouse's life, over your children. Stop saying what your circumstance is saying. Begin to say what God is saying about you. You are the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. You are blessed, you are not cursed. Begin to say what God says about you. It is very, very, very vital. Whatever you are going to experience tomorrow, you sow the seed today. That is very, very important. Another kind of seed you need to learn to sow is a seed of healthy living. It is not just enough to confess that I cannot be sick. It's not just enough to confess that by the stripes of Jesus I'm healed. You also need to act accordingly by being careful of what you eat, by taking adequate rest, discipline of your body. See, the dream of that matter is that you can be confessing positive and you are eating negative. Invariably, you are still going to fall sick. So you need to be very careful the kind of seed you sow into your life. As per your health, eat right, rest when it is necessary, and you must be able to discipline your body. The third kind that is just similar to what I just talked about is a seed of righteous living. It is also a seed. Bible says in Hebrews chapter 1 verse 9, referring to Jesus, says, because thou hast loved righteousness and you hate iniquity, the Lord your God has anointed with the oil of gladness above your contemporaries. So Jesus did sow the seed of righteousness and hate iniquity. And his harvest was the harvest of God lifting him above his contemporaries. Righteous living is key. Bible says we should be sanctified both from within our body, soul, and spirit. Now, the third kind of seed you need to learn to sow is the seed of kindness and the seed of love. How kind are you to people around you? How do you treat the stepdaughter in your custody? How do you treat your house girl? How do you treat your drivers? How do you treat your people under you at work? You need to learn to sow the seed of kindness and the seed of love. I know a woman, a widow, who was overtly hospitable to everybody that came her way. You know what happened when our children went to serve in different parts of the country? People were there to assist them because she had sown the seed of kindness. She must reap the seed of kindness and the seed of love. It is a very, very vital seed. The last one I'll just share with you because of our time is the seed of service. Service to God and being a good employee wherever God has placed you. You see, the truth of the matter is it is a seed. Bible says in Luke chapter 16 that if you are not faithful in that which belongs to other men, then yours cannot be given to you. Are you surprised that your people under you are doing what they like to do? Check yourself. You must have sown the wrong kind of seed while you were working under somebody. How faithful are you with the task that God has given to you? It is a seed. You cannot enter into tomorrow's harvest that is good if you are not ready to sow the seed today. I want to decree in the name of Jesus, every wrong seed has been sown into your life by ignorance. I decree that the blood of Jesus wipes them away. It's a new slate for you. Begin to consciously sow the right seed in the name of Jesus. I want to invite you to God's Chamber Church. We meet Sundays 8 a.m. and 9 a.m. in the morning, 3 Ajayi Road, off Yaya Baton, Aguda, Ogba, Lagos. The Lord bless you. I appreciate you in Jesus' name.
A place for you to grow.
A place for you to nurture your spiritual life.
And impact your world with the Word of God.
Worship with us at God's Chamber.
Every Sunday, 9 a.m. and Wednesday, 6 p.m.
Located at Glory House,
3 Ajayi Road, Ogwa.
For inquiries,
call 080-2340-4085.
Email
info@godschamber.org.ng.
God's Chamber, committed to your total transformation.